brothers and sisters, let's circle it up. Let's circle it up. Let's circle it up. Black power. Black power.
Black power.
Black power. Black power. Black power. Black power. Black power. All power to the people. All power to the people. All power to the people. Stop the violence.
Stop the violence.
Stop the violence. Stop the violence. Stop the violence.
All power to the people.
Give yourselves a strong backhand, brothers and sisters. Yes. We should be fired up today, brothers and sisters. We should be fired up despite the obstacles that are always before us. We still find a way to overcome those obstacles, brothers and sisters. Last week, we were attacked by the Irvington Police Department, in particular, Police Chief Chase, under his orders. They attacked our rally last week. They attacked our peace rally for a sister named Serena Baines, who was shot and killed in a drive-by shooting, along with two other brothers that were shot. We should say thank you because she was 6 months pregnant, so the baby that was inside of her womb was killed as well. You know, we came up here to organize the community to find solutions to the problems of violence that's affected the city of Irvington. A couple weeks before the Serena shooting, there were four students at Irvington High School that were shot in the drive-by. They survived, but they were shot in the drive-by. Around Irvington High School. So that city has a problem with violence. So we were called up there to organize a peace rally. And instead of the police trying to work with us to find some solutions to the problem, they attacked our rally. They attacked our peace rally. But we weren't deterred, brothers and sisters. The Newark Anti-Violence Coalition, we believe the victims. Is that right, brothers and sisters? Let me hear you, brothers and sisters.
Stop the violence.
The issue of violence that's plaguing our community, black community, the Latino community in the city of Newark and the metropolitan area. We got word a couple of weeks ago there was a shoot where two people were shot, one in critical condition. But that's the mentality we have, unfortunately, today. We'd rather shoot and kill people, particularly our people, we'd rather shoot and kill people. As opposed to finding peaceful solutions to the